chairman of the Council of Ministers of the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, Nikita Khrushchev. Mobile units of WHO-TV, KRNT-TV, and WOI-TV are being used in this special pool telecast.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jack Shelley speaking from the Des Moines Municipal Airport, where a mood of expectancy has been gathering now for many hours and is just about at the peak at this moment, as we anticipate that if the latest announcement is correct, Premier Khrushchev's plane will be landing here in a matter of only a couple of minutes. We have been watching for the last several hours, those of us who have been here during that time, the first 707 jet airplanes, which most of us have seen, touching down one by one at the Des Moines Municipal Airport. The first one was a commercial jet plane, which bore about 125 members of the press, radio, and TV party, all of whom have been preceding the Russian premier as he makes his stops all the way across the country. And then, one by one, we have seen other jets of the type you're looking at right now, planes operated by the U.S. Air Force and used by the Military Air Transport Service for so-called VIP flights, which have been bringing in first another collection of radio, TV, and press people, then the last one arriving only about 5 minutes or so ago, carried with it men and women of what might be called somewhat secondary importance with the Russian party. Now you can see those who are watching the crowd gathered at the scene. We're viewing at the present moment people who are standing on the side of the airport runway, where the crowds will be greeting the Russian premier. And we are at the same time watching what is going on as the members of the press assemble on a large truck body, which has been assembled to one side here, and which has mounted at the present time on it something like 8 or a dozen sound and still motion picture cameras to be used in the coverage of Khrushchev's arrival. Off in another direction, while the members of the military police and the Air National Guard stand expectantly waiting to move forward with the ramp, which will provide the stairway by which Khrushchev will come down from his plane. In other directions, we see various members of the group of dignitaries who are going to extend an official welcome for the city of Des Moines and for the state of Iowa. Among those waiting, of course, and by the way, at the very moment that I am speaking, you are looking what appears to me to be the convertible car in which the Russian premier will ride. He was given his choice, we understood, of having either a closed air-conditioned limousine or this open one of the convertible type. And the weather, while it has been a little doubtful, and while there is a forecast of possible thunderstorm conditions this afternoon, right now seems to be fairly favorable for his ride downtown, and it looks to us as though they're going to prepare the convertible that you see for his ride downtown. There has been a great crowd gathering along McKinley Avenue, which runs down to Fleur Drive, along the fences just outside the south end, or I should say the north end, of the Des Moines Airport, trying to get whatever glimpse they can. Perhaps you can see in the distance now some of the people gathered there beyond the airport fence. You are looking over the heads of the photographers and some of the dignitaries. There are more newsmen than anybody else in this group that you are watching in the immediate foreground, who are watching for the arrival of the Khrushchev plane. We are told by others of our news staff who are handling this pool broadcast for the Central Iowa television stations, we are told that there are downtown now in the vicinity of Hotel Fort Des Moines something in excess of 1,000 persons, that police are already on hand controlling the crowds there, and moreover we are told that there have been some signs of protesting groups visible in the vicinity of the Fort Des Moines Hotel. For a brief run down to the other places, we're going to take a look right now at the Fort Des Moines Hotel site, where later on you will see Chairman Khrushchev of the Council of Ministers of the Union of Socialist Soviet Republics as he arrived. Here you are looking in the area at the corner of the Fort Des Moines Hotel there at 9th and Walnut. Notice the tremendous crowd of people gathered there on the parking ramp, on that unique and circular parking ramp, which undoubtedly offers a wonderful place from which to view Khrushchev's arrival at the hotel. Now here you see some of the people who are standing at barricades, and there are some signs, as you can see, expressing sentiments of one kind or another. Notice that the police in the 9th and Walnut area have people kept pretty firmly behind these barricades, and of course they'll be kept well back, we understand, at the time when the premier does arrive at the hotel. Now you're getting a look actually into a portion of the hotel itself, and you can see people waiting on the route and over the red carpet which Khrushchev will tread on as he enters the Fort Des Moines Hotel. From this position, we are going to move to our other pickup point at 14th and Locust, the intermediate point on the pickup, and we hope that from there we'll be able to get a view of the Premier after he has left the airport. For the moment, though, we're going to return to the Des Moines Airport and take a look at, again, at the jet planes which have borne the advance members of the party, and at the scenes which are to be found here at the airport as we wait for the arrival of the Russian Premier's plane. Notice here, this is a house just across from the airport side, not at all distant from the place where the F-86 jet fighters of the Iowa Air National Guard are customarily based. And you'll see that while it is not a packed crowd, that there are substantial numbers of people there who have been building up over the course of the last several hours. Some of those cars over there, which you can see on the other side of McKinley, some of those cars have been there since 8 o'clock this morning, as some people came out to choose advantageous spots. The crowd of pedestrians has really just built up, I would say, within the last hour to any size. Just before we came on the air with our broadcast from the scene, I walked over to the gate of the Air National Guard base and saw that there were substantial numbers of people lined up most of the way down Fleur Drive, or I should say McKinley, to Fleur Drive. Now we're taking another look at the scene where the members of the party of official greeters are waiting to give Khrushchev his welcome to the state of Iowa and the city of Des Moines. Among those in the party who are going to be welcoming the governor, welcoming Khrushchev, of course, are the governor, Governor and Mrs. Lovelace, Lieutenant Governor and Mrs. Edward McManus, Mayor and Mrs. Charles Isles of Des Moines, Mr. and Mrs. Frank Depute, he is the president of the Chamber of Commerce, and Mr. and Mrs. John Adams, John Adams, of course, being the executive secretary of the Greater Des Moines Chamber of Commerce. And while they are waiting, as you can see, it's almost impossible to distinguish between those who are members of the official greeting party and those who are among the hordes of newsmen gathered here to cover this event. There have been throughout the afternoon different versions, one time saying 1:25 would be his arrival time, on other occasions that 1:45 would be his arrival time, and then just as we took the air, the word was that he'd be here by now, that at approximately 1:26 p.m., Premier Khrushchev, flying in from San Francisco, California, in a Boeing 707 jet of the United States Air Force, would have landed here. Here is the entrance to the Iowa Air National Guard's quarters out here, and this is the place where the dignitaries had gathered, first of all, in order to get ready for the arrival of the Russian Premier. There's quite a lineup of cars already in formation, police cars and civilian-type cars, also those known as pool cars carrying photographers for radio and for television. And we are now taking a look at that long lineup of cars, each of them in its proper place, each one bearing a number designating its place in the parade. And now we're back again to the men who are waiting at parade rest out there by the ramp which Khrushchev will be using. Those who are familiar with the Des Moines area, and in particular the Des Moines Fire Department, might be interested to know that Lieutenant John Connors, the red-haired man who for so many years has been a spokesman for the Des Moines firefighters, is going to drive the car which Governor Lovelace and Khrushchev are expected to ride in for just a very short time. As a matter of fact, Johnny was telling us just before we came on the air that he expects to drive the car only as far as the place where Khrushchev will enter it, here on the edge of the airport runway, and that then President Eisenhower's own personal driver will take over the wheel of Khrushchev's car. Now let's take another look downtown and see how things are coming on at some of the other points where pickups are being made. Here we are once more downtown in the vicinity of the route that will be traveled by the Russian Premier. As you can see, there are very large crowds on hand around the Fort Des Moines there, but you can also see that there are some protest signs. There's one which reads, "The only good communist is a dead one." And the D is just a little bit out of place in the middle there, isn't it? A rather hasty job, perhaps, of sign making, but a demonstration that there are those who are protesting.